Past paper questions revisions. In this lesson, we are going to revise a question on similarity and congruency, which is one of the challenging topics in the syllabus, and many candidates and teachers avoid these types of questions, but we are going to simplify this. I will try to highlight simple methods of solving this. In this question from 2004, it is given in the diagram PQ, this is P and Q, is parallel to UV, it's parallel to UV, is shown by these arrows, which shows the lines are parallel. PQ is 9 and UV is 6, then VR from this distance to this distance is 8 centimeters. First question, name in correct order the triangle which is similar to triangle VUR. VUR in correct order, want to name a triangle which is similar to that. Therefore, in this case, we use angles, always use angles to correctly name a similar or a congruent shape. Therefore, I will use angles since we are given parallel lines, we can use alternate angles. So here in red, these are equal angles according to the effects of angles. If we are given parallel lines, we can there's formation of alternate angles, so this in red is equal to this, then this in purple is equal to this. So we are saying angle at P is equal to angle at Q, then angle at P is equal to angle at U, and angle at Q is equal to angle at V. Then these triangles are sharing the same angle at R. Therefore, we can name them V, U, V at red, then U at purple, then R at blue. So we can follow that same order, Q at red, P at purple, and R at blue. This means V, triangle VUR is similar to triangle QPR. So that was the correct answer. Then we want to calculate the length of VQ. To find this, we cannot find this directly, but we have to find the length of QR by using a similarity ratio. We can easily calculate a similarity ratio or a scale ratio here, 9:6, 9 for the large triangle and 6 for the small triangle, since these are the corresponding sides of similar shapes. Therefore, our scale ratio is 3/2 or 1.5. We can therefore multiply that by the given length of 8. Therefore, 3/2 times 8, this will give me 12. You punch this into a calculator if you are in paper 2, since you are allowed to use scientific calculators. So 3/2 times 8 is equal to 12. Therefore, we subtract 8 from 12 to find the length of VQ. Bear in mind that here 12 is for QR and we are given VR is 8, so we subtract from 12 to find VQ, which is 4. So the answer was 4 here. And the last question, which is a bit challenging, given that the area of the triangle VUR is 32 square centimeters, calculate the area of the trapezium. You can see that there's the difference of the large triangle and the small triangle. So we use the area ratio, which is a square of the scale ratio, to find the area of the large triangle QPR. Therefore, we're given that this is 32 square centimeters, so we want to find this. Then we have corresponding sides 9 and 6. The ratio now, with the scale ratio, we want to use the area ratio. Area ratio is equal to 3/2 squared, which is 9/4. That is the area ratio. Then we use that area ratio to find the area of the large triangle. So just multiply by the given area. 9/4 times 32, so this will give me 72. This means the area of the large triangle is 72, then the area of the small is 32. To find this area of the trapezium, we just have to subtract the two. Area is 72 minus 40, 72 minus 32 is equals to 40. This means the area of the trapezium is 40 square centimeters. So that's the easiest way you can solve this. So this marks the end of our lesson. So here we can write the area of triangle VUR is 32 as given here. Then we used the ratio to find 72. So 72 minus 32 is 40. So the area of the trapezium is 40. You can see that if you add 40 plus 32, it will also give us 72. So that's how you are supposed to collect these 7 marks.